Hi, my name is Justin Odisho, and in this episode of Every Filter in Photoshop Explained, we're going to be covering the Liquify tool. So Liquify is an interesting one. It's its own little plugin in the filter menu. And if I press that Liquify tool, it'll open up its own little settings and menu. And here we have our toolbar on the left and some other menus and properties on the right. So first of all, the basic Liquify tool is, let's just say, this finger smudge. I can click and drag and smudge around and liquify. And I can always Command Z or undo, edit, undo that, just like anything else in Photoshop. But some other cool things about Liquify are the new face aware tools and properties, such as automatically being able to detect eye size. You can see here, I'm not even doing anything. It just kind of knows where the right and left eye are. I can change the height and width of things. I mean, you could say it's cool, you could say it's scary, but we could detect this information. We could change nose, mouth shape, even go from a frown to a smile, change lip amount. So this will work on portraits, really. It won't necessarily work on a picture of a tree. But you have all type of face-aware Liquify tools to automatically do that. That's what that is. And then also, you just have the properties of your brush. So you see here, the circle is about 700 in size, but I can make it smaller if I want to just smudge certain things, or I can make it bigger if I want to just do large smudges in general. So you can also use the shortcuts left bracket and right bracket, just as you can with the paintbrush tool, and that helps. You can also change the density and the pressure and the rate of the brush. So if I lower the density and the pressure, you see I can pull, but it'll be a lot weaker. It's as if it's a softer touch. But if I increase the density and the pressure all the way up, you see it's dragging a lot more and a lot stronger. Some other basic things you have are the reconstruction options. So sometimes you might have pushed things a little too far. You like the direction it's going, but you want to fade it kind of. If I click reconstruct, I can just lower the strength. So here's 0, here's 100, but I can just kind of maybe pull things back to 50%. So that way, if I overshot, I can go back to what I wanted. Or I can just click restore all to get back to the default. But again, that's not taking the face aware in mind. I could always just reset that by clicking the reset button. And then also, aside from just the finger smudge tool, you have lots of different kinds of brushes. So let's say I was smudging. I have the reconstruction tool as well. It's kind of like the reconstruct button, but in this case, you can just reconstruct a certain area. So I can try to reconstruct the pupil area a little bit, and I want to bring that lip edge back. I can do that as well. It's kind of like an eraser tool or an undistort tool. You also have a smooth tool, which is similar to that reconstruction tool, but it will try to smooth between two edges. And then you also have a twirl tool. This is interesting. It's kind of like the twirl filter that's in the distort menu that I'll show you. But in this case, if I just press and hold, it'll kind of just put the image through a blender. The same type of things apply to these four tools, the pucker, bloat, and push. I can just click and hold and it will kind of suck everything in like a blender or a vacuum. And on the opposite end, we have the expand or bloat tool. And this is where that rate feature that wasn't available on the earlier brushes comes in handy. The higher the rate, the faster it kind of blends, or the blending strength happens. The lower the rate, the slower it will kind of go. We also have the push left tool. Again, this is kind of, you see how this is kind of pushing pixels around. And these are the masking tools that I mentioned. For example, let's say I just didn't want her finger or her hand to get distorted at all, but I wanted to be able to distort everything around it. I could kind of draw in a mask, and then as I brush, no matter what I do, the areas that I masked don't really get affected and they stay there. So in the right hand side, I could click none and it'll remove those masks if I want. But you see, I kept her finger in place as I worked around it. And lastly, the face tool, it's kind of just tying along with the face aware Liquify, except in this case, you can click and point around. You see, it's doing the same thing as the sliders, but it just gives you the visual option for doing it. But that's the Liquify filter and whole little menu explained. And once you press OK, you can commit to your changes. And again, just like everything else, if you are working with smart filters on a smart layer, you can have your Liquify tool under a smart filter menu. And then you can lower the opacity and change the blending modes and things like that. But you see, lowering the opacity is not the same as lowering the reconstruction strength in the filter menu. So you can always double click it back, go back into your Liquify and change or reconstruct things as you like. If you enjoyed this video, you can check out all of my Photoshop filter explained tutorials in a playlist on my channel. My name is Justin Odisho. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.